Okay, so here we are. And you ask the question, and then I'll just put it right back to you.
Okay, take a little step forward. There you go.
Okay.
All right, so, you know, the UN was willing to screen this film, and they were willing to endorse it, and then all of a sudden they're bowing out. Talk about what you think the UN involvement in our country and also in the global stratosphere and the climate and rainforest specifically, whose side are they on?
As you've heard before, the United Nations had screened this film and, or the early footage, and had approved of it, and then they seemed to bow out all of a sudden. Well, here's what I've got to say about the United Nations. If you are the United Nations, freaking act like it, okay? We need to come together to solve this problem. Everything is connected. You've got rainforests that are helping out with the carbon dioxide that's killing us, that we are emitting on a daily basis, that is just mind-boggling. It's killing us. And then when we take and we slash the rainforest like this, I mean, it's killing us quicker. You're the United Nations. Please get all the nations together on the same page. There's all the data. It's all there. Everybody can see it. We don't need to screw around with this. This is really urgent. And if nobody can see how they're all connected, again, that app that I told you about shows you at jpl.nasa.gov, Earth Now. I mean, it is really, you can see how everything's connected, how, it, you know, one thing that I took away from that rocket scientist on the plane back was that, there are no boundaries, really, with regards to nations. We could think that there are, right? But when a volcano explodes or carbon dioxide emits throughout the planet, do you think it says, oh, North Carolina, can I cross over into your border? Or China, can I go into yours? No, it doesn't give a crap because it just spreads. And what do we do about it? We slowly die. Our air dies. We're killing off the rainforest. And, you know, the rainforests are the key to the future. Number one, they're going to give us the oxygen that we need. They're going to remove the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere that we need to breathe. And that's not even talking about so many other things I haven't even figured out yet. They're going in and they're finding, like, little plants that, oh, by the way, the side effect of this strange little plant that we found that we just trampled over with a tractor, oh, that cures leukemia. Are you kidding me? These things should be treated as special resources, precious resources, because we don't even know what they have. We don't know what they have to offer. We don't know what wonderful things, the things that we think we know about, we don't know crap. We really don't. We need to save the rainforest. We need to explore the rainforest. We need to come together as all nations under the United Nations. It makes me wonder what that organization is really doing. If this is not one of the most important things on its agenda, then what are they doing? What are they worried about? Nintendo? Their Jaguars? Their gold palaces? It's crazy. This is our planet. We only got one shot. We should make it the best.
Look in the small camera and say, whose side are you on?
United Nations? Or about the United? Okay. Okay.
And then do it about anyway.
Okay. As a species, you got to ask yourself one question. It's like the Clint Eastwood. Sorry. As a species, you've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Like Clint Eastwood would say, whose side are you on? Are you on our side? Or are you on your own selfish side? Are you on the side of, you know, having a planet that sustains us and your children's children? Or are you about, sorry, it blew me out of the fucking water.
All right, we're going on. Whose side are you on?
Okay, let's see. The ear, I can hear that in the, on the sound, Kurt.
Yeah, I can hear them.
We can hear the headpiece, Kurt.
I know you can.
Oh, okay.
I know, but I still have to hear what she's saying because it's really important to the film.
I got you.
Continue. What were you saying? I walked on the set and it threw everything off. So what were you saying? Finish what you were saying, please.
Wow, that's...
To you. Please finish so we can get recording. Great. And find out her ETA. Thanks. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, sorry, I'm going to throw that down in a second.
It's okay.
Okay, let's just dive in because I've got other people's starting to stack up. I apologize, but I had to put out a fire.
So we got a lot of stuff.
I know you're doing. That's why I said I'll probably have more than I need to cut.
Perfect.
From already,
okay, so now whose side are you on? Okay, okay, here we go. To both? Okay, both? Okay, let's see. Growing up, everybody had a favorite team. Basketball, soccer, baseball. Well, there's another team that I'd like to talk to you about. It's called the human race, okay? United Nations, be damned. Whose side are you on? Are you for the good team or are you for the bad team? You know, we can talk about conjecture and, you know, and ramble all day. At the end of the day, our planet's dying. There's things that we can do about it. There's things that you specifically can do about it. And all you gotta do is sign up, raise your hand. Don't run your water, run your water a little less when you're shaving. Don't have it. Shit, sorry about that. We went off on a tangent. I think we got the message across,
yeah.
Right? Okay,
just
good.
Just give me a one-off. Whose side are you on?
Okay, yeah. Okay, so whose side are you on? Are you on the side of the human race? Are you on the side of the United Nations? Are you on the side of our planet? Well, unfortunately,
I'm on the industrial race, man. I'm industrial over here.
Yeah. Well, if you're siding with the United Nations, well, it looks like they're siding against our planet. And that's not a good thing. Let's sign up for the human race. Let's sign up for the planet. I'm in.
Okay. So, what they don't want us to tell you, mm-hmm. 5, maybe 10 years tops, your app tells us we're probably a lot closer to that 2 centigrade that if we hit, we go into meltdown. Extinction rates at record proportions that now your grandchildren, if they are here beyond 5 or 10 years, will be watching things in photos or videos because they don't exist anymore.
Yes.
What does extinction mean to you?
Think about it. Have you ever said goodbye to a loved one, somebody that you knew, and they're just not there anymore? Well, in moving forward, that's exactly where we're headed. It's not going to be in my time. And you know, I wish I could do more about that. If you don't think about yourself, think about your children, think about your children's children. What are they going to do? What are they going to do when they're looking back on what used to be our world? And they say, gee, daddy, what was that? Oh, that was a dolphin. Or what was that? That was a chimpanzee. Or those were dogs. Yeah, we ate all the dogs because there's no food left. And there's so many. I'm sorry. And guess who's next on the grill, little boy? You know, I'm just saying. It's a bleak reality. It's a stark reality. It is nuts. You can change all this. We can change all this. We just have to come together. It gets me angry to even think about such a thing. But at the end of the day, we can change our world, and we can change our future. What are you going to do?
You're a tree hugger.
Hate trees. No, I love trees. Kidding. I had to throw it up there. Yeah, I'm a tree hugger. Why the heck shouldn't I be? I mean, I should probably high-five trees if I could. At the end of the day, I am trying to breathe. They are helping me out. What's not to love? We're doing slash and burn operations, not showing them any love. It seems like the United Nations isn't doing anything to stop that. In fact, they're kind of encouraging it. I don't know what else to say about that. I'm a tree hugger, and I'm pissed off.
Are you a forest hugger?
I'm a forest lover. I'm an equal opportunity lover, and forests.
Cool. So, the Charter of the UN, by the way, this is the 70th anniversary of the UN. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah. 2015 marks 70 years. So we've all been getting together, getting along in New York City.
I hate the UN, actually.
So the UN Charter, as published as of this date of this taping right now in 2015, mm-hmm. says that they help with environment, health, human and humanitarian interests, etc. Mm-hmm. And they were helping with the film mm-hmm. for about a couple of weeks until they might have found out we might want to tell the truth about this and not candy coat it. Mm-hmm. How does it make you feel knowing that your world leaders, your forefathers.
Mm-hmm. They always blame the younger generation. The kids screw it up, man. The riots, the races, all this stuff. Mm-hmm. But it's the older generation that fucked it up for us. How do you feel about that? And how do you feel about the guys who are that older generation, that's maybe you and I, that are running the world today, that are still making those same dumbass decisions that greed is more important than error? Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you how this makes me feel. And, you know, quite frankly, I don't care what you feel right now. I've got to get this out. Everybody has to know about this. Listen, the United Nations, it's the 70th anniversary this year, I think in 2015. They're supposed to find ingenious ways for us all to all come together, protect our planet, move forward culturally, move forward as a civilization collectively. And, the more that I'm looking at this, we're going backwards. I mean, there are so many things that we can do. We can work together to We can work together to collectively sustain. We can move together forward for a collective sustainability. And that's in everything that we do. Not just, our economy, our commerce. But this is, with regards to, if you're going to cut down a tree, plant another 5. If you're going to do this, do that. We've got to think for the future. And we're not. We're eating up this oxygen. We're eating up our planet at an alarming rate. The waters are rising.